All right, welcome back. We have finally made it into our third game of the night here between Scarsdale High School and East Chapel Hill. So let's get right into it and introduce our players. Here on the Radiant side for East Chapel is going to be Fudge playing the Omni Knight. We've got Keeper of the Light, handled by Villain, a bit of a change up from his normal Disruptor. We've got Storm Spirit. Oh, man, he's a little bit naked. Somebody should put some clothes on that guy. He's played by FCY. Just went a little bit too much skin there. Probably going to get us banned on Twitch. Morphling would be handled by Three Body. Got a nice little hat there. And finally, the next assassin in the offlane is going to be Wraith Cat. Now, on the Dire side again for Scarsdale High School is going to be Freedom Fries. Sorry, Mar playing the Alchemist. I wasn't even on him. Faceless Void played by Freedom Fries. We've got Sand King. We 301 again. Been basically playing the same hero this entire time. Undying will be played by Flounder. And finally, the Warlock is going to be Malone for Scarsdale High School. All right. So, East Chapel. Gonna be hanging out near the rune spot. So let's give that over to the Storm Spirit, who probably is gonna be wanting to put some clothes on pretty soon. He's gonna get really cold like that. Showing those man boobs. Jesus. Oh, man. Well, anyway. Alchemist is going to be hanging out on the mid lane. Goes for the first level into Grievous Greed. Has picked up the Bounty Rune, so he's got a ton of gold, getting two slippers of agility for his PMS now. So, Alchemist is just going to be sitting in the mid lane. Doesn't get that last hit there. Very important when you get... Oh my gosh. Can we stop actually disconnecting from the game? Would really like if we could. I would really like if we could actually get through a game without all these disconnects. Bottom lane. It's got three heroes here and a Morphling. Morphling shouldn't get too much pressure put onto him, but when you play an Undying against the Morphling and you go for so much agility, you're really forced into a little bit more health just because the Decay takes a lot of your strength away. So the Morphling isn't really going to have a whole lot. Yeah. Eventually, these players are going to make it back in, but Scarsdale might want to work on their internet connections pretty soon. Ugh. Let's take a look at our hero models. It's all about the cosmetics, right? Oh, wait. Let's take a look at that guy. Hey. He's like, you want to buy some of the stuff? You want to buy some of that? And Nyx Assassin, let's take a look at Nyx. What does Nyx have to say? He's like, yes, Nyx. Let's make a little story, actually. So Nyx walked into the side shop one day, and he said, Nyx. And the side shop owner says, no, I don't have a Hyperstone here. You're going to have to buy that somewhere else. They have that at the secret shop. I don't have that here. I'm not trusted with it. So the Nyx Assassin said, Nyx. And the side shop owner said, I don't care how much you're going to give me for it. I can't give you a Hyperstone here. So the Nyx Assassin said, Nyx. And the guy said, no, you can't kill me. You can't even do damage to me on the Dota map. So the Nyx Assassin said, Nyx. And then that was the end of the story. The shopkeeper died 5 days later. He's got some nice abs there. don't even know why Void has to have abs. Hasn't got a whole lot of cosmetics either. Of course, we've already looked at the naked Storm Spirit. Alchemist is looking really fierce. He's like looking off to the side. He's like, man, I hate this guy. His eyes even aren't even moving. He's twitching though. Do you see that? He's twitching a little bit. Ooh. What is he actually hitting there? What is Caudle hitting with his little blast? Is this some kind of is this some kind of erotic stuff? Why is he hitting Sand King there? It's very strange. Let's see what else we have. We also have Undying. He's very ugly. I don't understand why he has to walk like that. But his mouth is still moving at least. I like most of the Morphling sets. I think some of them are pretty cool. He's only got a hat, though. No, he's got some other things. They all blend in, though. These are on the back of his arms. Alright, so we'll get back into this game now. We'll continue our Sand King and Caudle erotica. Looks like someone's AFK. Yeah, I think someone's still AFK. I think someone's also very, very dead. Look at... look how sad he is. And his horse, too. His horse is like, oh, gosh darn it. Not again. Poor guy. Well, both teams. Oh, he said he's G. He doesn't look G though. I'm pretty sure he's dead. Alright. I don't even think that letting the Caudle live is going to do anything. So, Flounder takes the first blood, and 301 goes forward onto the Omni Knight. There is not a burst trick available. He's still level 1. Dying uses that decay. Going to go right for the creep wave. Doesn't even care right now. Three of those decay stacks up. Sand King doesn't get the last hit. Fawn is going to be taking some harass from the backside. Does have a decay available, but these heroes start to get away. One of the things that you have to do against an Undying is you have to make sure that you're never in range for that double decay. And, well, they get another kill onto the Omni Knight, so not really working well around that at all. Storm Spirit gonna not be doing so well in the mid lane. Misses that hit uphill onto the Alchemist. Makes his way out of the Acid Spray. Well, Mark's taking a lot of damage here. Can't really stick around all that long. Luckily, the Storm Spirit didn't have enough mana for the Static Remnant. Nice little hit there for Alchemist. Now Warlock makes his way over to the mid lane, looking for a Shadow Word, and Storm Spirit steps up into it. Not sure why he would want to do that, but the Tango is going to heal him up enough. East Chapel have to be really careful of the Caustic Finale. They can't really stick around this creep wave too long. Impel is going to be off the mark from the Nyx Assassin. Doesn't really do any work in terms of CS either. And Storm Spirit's still very low. Marco's underneath the tower a little bit, but he does have the bottle charges to heal himself back up. And, well, the Storm Spirit now knows that Warlock has the Invis rune. Storm Spirit gets that nice little last hit, and he's taking some damage here from the Fatal Bonds. I don't think he's going to go down. Alchemist really just wants to get the last hits, but no, he gets taken down to 80 health. Meanwhile, inside the Radiant Jungle, Omni just killed off by... He gets killed off by the Undying just running around. Puts down a ward behind the tower, forcing a couple of creeps over to this side. Just a little deny here for the guys. But body's still taking a lot of harass from this. So the creep wave is going to push underneath the tower. And maybe looking for a kill onto the Coddle. Getting caught out by the creeps a little bit there. Tombstone going to be dropped. And Keeper the Light doesn't have a whole lot of health to get through this. Wanda did take a lot of damage, but the Morphling waveforms a little bit in the wrong direction. Undying. Once he heal up a little bit, there's going to be the healing salve to get him there. Sand King, low on mana. But the Tombstone is gone now. The Alchemist leaves Warlock on the mid lane for a little bit longer, just to get a couple of levels. Should be at nearly level 3, as there's now a double damage rune for the Alchemist. Has a lot of gold. On the courier right now is his Helm of Ironwall, making him a bit more tanky in the mid lane. Over at bottom, we've got a lot more damage coming through. Villain trying to make his way away from here. 3-1 around the side. Eventually, that repel is going to end. And the last hit goes to the Undying. I'm not even sure. He didn't use a decay for that. Somehow, he hit him. And that was a pretty long-range melee. Now the creep wave gets pushed in by the Sand King. 2 levels into the Caustic Finale. They're going right for the Omni-Net as well. They just want to get through the creep wave. They should be able to clear it pretty quickly. Oh no. Missing that Caustic Finale. Definitely helped them take the creep wave down faster. So now Morphling's forced to deal with the creep wave underneath his tower. Coddle gets the vision over the trees there. Again, has to be careful. Can't really go in on this too much. Taking a look at his build, he's not got any points into the Illuminate, which has definitely fallen a little bit out of favor with Mana Leak becoming a lot more popular. Deflander gets a decay off Radiant's around the trees. Sand King has a Burrow Strike available, just gets it out onto the Morphling. Now Storm Spirit comes in from the side. There's going to be the Stag's Remnant doing some damage. Sand King, he doesn't want to fall as well, but Storm Spear has the Ball Lightning, just not a whole lot of mana. Definitely needs his Soul Ring to do more damage here, and it's not really going to happen. So both the Sand King and Undying get away from that very deep dive, and it also forces out the rotation by the Storm Spirit, who allows the Warlock to just farm as much as he wants on mid. Alchemist has gone into the jungle, getting some nice of those nice stacks off. And he should have his armlet after this stack. 50. Okay, he could get another stack off again. Being as efficient as he can. I don't know if he pulled it far enough away. Yeah, he didn't pull that creep wave, that creep camp far enough to get the stock off.
You get nothing.
Yeah, Void also doing well at top. Pretty well against the Nyx Assassin. He's at 10 last hits for now. At bottom, again, Sand King comes in with a double burrow strike. Undying throws down the tombstone. Oh, Fudge absolutely wrecked there. Body trying to do as much damage as he can, and he just can't really live against the Caustic Finale stacks. Now Villain forced away all these zombies chasing him down. Double kill for the Sand King at the bottom lane. He's dominating right now. 4-0-4. That's an error if you ask me. Just making it so that East Chapel cannot live at all on the bottom lane. He's not pressuring a whole lot onto the tower, not really staying there at all. Oh, he goes into the rune. He could get the Storm Spirit. That's going to be no rune for that guy. Also, you're double damage rune there. Sandy Claws. Oh, man. Sand King dropping the items. It's a lot of BM here.
Double damage.
It's so much BM. Yeah, he's just kind of taunting the Storm Spirit for going over there. Radiant's middle and now he comes in with a double damage rune, going right for the Morphling. That's the only thing that he has eyes for. Working through these creep waves so quickly. Oh no, the Coddle. This is not where he wanted to be. The Sand King does way too much damage. Villain can't back out. That's another death by the Coddle. Again, Sand King has another Burrow Strike, thinking about going on to the Morphling, who gets the repel on him from the Omni Knight. So Sand King loses that double damage rune, but he already did enough damage with it. Warlock did get killed off at mid. That's just the Storm Spirit going in. Warlock just trying to get up to level 6, and he's nearly there. Tombstone gets dropped down at bottom. Purification comes through. Nyx Assassin is going to be there. Could be looking for a good impale, and he will hit it on the 2. Nice Burrow Strike comes through, and actually the big Caustic Finale pops both the Omni Knight as well as the Morphling. Nyx Assassin gets a Shadow Word on him. He's in trouble. Goes back underneath the Tombstone. That's really where he doesn't want to end up being. 3 kills at bottom for Scarsdale. That is a dominating streak going the way of East Chapel Hill, but still a lot of gold over to Scarsdale. And the tower, it's fortified, but it should end up going down here. Tower is very low. For some reason, Scarsdale not going for that. And the deny, it's going to be there. Now Malone in basically no man's land, tries to get up to level 6, is actually there right now. But you can't drop a rock when you're dead. And he also didn't have enough mana for it. So Mars just working around the map as much as he can right now. Nearly at his Radiance as well. This is going to be such a difficult game for East Chapel, rather, when that gets built up. You're going to have to be dealing with the Radiance Alchemist, which already has the courier sent to the secret shop right now. It's a very fast relic. He's basically gone into the jungle very early and wasn't contested at all there. He's clearing out these creeps faster than they can respawn. He goes back over towards the mid lane. Level 10 right now. He's going to get some good farm from this as well. Just working really well with the Iron Talon, being as efficient as possible. And his Radiance isn't going to be too far behind. At the bottom lane, wow, these heroes are underneath their tier 2 tower, and they cannot even live here. Sand King, unfortunately, doesn't have another Burrow Strike there for the Omni Knight, but it really doesn't matter at all. Rock also still available for the Warlock. Nyx Assassin, can they actually do enough damage here? Looking for the Vendetta hit onto the Void. Still looking for it. Oh, Morphling gets ganked on mid. We'll go for a waveform through. Will they? No, they don't have enough mana for the rock. So they're not going to drop it just yet. Do force some Morphling away from the mid lane, though. Boy, trying to stay alive at the top lane. Here comes some Vendetta hit on the Freedom Fries. Is he going to get caught out here? There's a lot of damage, and eventually he does. Undying does show up here, but it might be another kill for the Storm Spear. Fonder taking a lot of damage here, and, well, he uses the mechanism to try to stay alive. That was a very early build-up, but he gets killed off by the Impale, hit by the Nyx Assassin. Now Storm Spear in trouble. That should be a pop on the Classic Finale. Can he actually TP back to base? No. One more hit from the Sand King just Radiant's pops him there. Now Malone comes in. He's got a rock available for the Nyx Assassin. All right, there's a Vendetta getting him away. Sentry Ward placed down, but Nyx Assassin already gets out. And there's a Radiance already for the Alchemist. Pinged out by Fudge. He says, oh my god. That is a 13-minute Radiance. And, you know, the Alchemist, he's already nearly at his next item. I'm assuming it's going to be Boost of Travel for him. It's either that or Yasha.
Radiant structures are fortified.
This Alchemist, you can see why it's been banned out basically every time. All right, so yeah, Alchemist just farming up a lot. And it's going to be
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, it's going to be hard to take him down. He builds up the Boots of Travel here.
Radiant's top tower has fallen. Radiant's middle tower has been denied.
So the rest of Scarsdale High School, they're going to try to work around the Alchemist as best as they can. He has his boots of travel right now. He's working around the map very quickly. Undying very far, and he's already going for wards inside the base. Scarsdale just so confident right now. They haven't even gotten through the tier 2, and they're already putting wards into the base. Oh, Void nearly caught out again. In fact, there's just no chance to get off the corner here. Nice triple chaotic offering from the Warlock. And there's an epicenter right under the Storm Spirit, making him really pay for going onto the Void there. Alchemist hasn't even joined this. He's over at bottom, just pushing this in. Man, they don't even need him for this. Rock putting so much pressure on the tower. They won't be taking it down very quickly at all, especially without the Void up. Oh no, Nyx Assassin. Well, nice play, Carapace helps to secure the kill onto the Undying. Rock is still alive, but does get killed off there. Sand King, very low mana, blinks out. And Mar, he's basically soloing this tier 2. No one's even going to try to defend it. There is a Fortify available. Okay, here comes the Storm Spirit. Can they kill him off? The ultimate's nearly down, but there's still an armlet available. There's really no chance of getting through this Alchemist's health. He's fine. So Mar just goes over to the rune spot, going to find another bounty rune for him. As if he needs any more gold, up to a Yasha right now. It's going to be Manta style soon. Nyx Assassin's here, but the ultimate's already been used by Mar. Here comes the Storm. Do they have enough damage? They're not really able to do enough, but eventually they can kill him. Oh my gosh. That's a huge kill for East Chapel to have. The highest net worth on the board by far. The next person's about halfway on his net worth, and that's a 2,000 gold kill. Undying does put a ward on the high ground. I believe that was scoured out, at least by the Nyx Assassin. I think he was paying it, but Undying is invisible here. Don't see the Nyx Assassin, but they do see a couple of other heroes here. Malone goes forward. Oh, Impale's gonna miss. A little bit of the mana taken away, And, oh, okay, Cottle is completely left out to dry there. Sand King, another blink in 3 seconds to go for Wraith Cat, who uses the Spike Carapace a little bit preemptively. Here comes a Burrow Strike, though. Can they actually kill off the Storm Spirit? They'll get the ball in the way, looking for the... Whoa! Chronosphere just a little bit off the mark. Very difficult to get that onto a Storm Spirit, but he does use most of his mana for it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
So the tier 2 tower, the way of Scarsdale High School. And exactly what can East Chapel do against this Alchemist? Sand King a little bit far in. Villain nearly taken down. Mars working his way into the lane. Okay, Sand King in some trouble, getting blocked out a little bit by the Alchemist. He'll just zip zap away. Here comes the concoction. Mars going to stun himself outside of the Radiant base. 15 seconds left to his next ultimate, but they'll just back up for now. Working, trying to do as much work as he can top. Just TPing away from there. So Alchemist working on his Manta style. He's just getting through the items super fast. All these creeps popping to the Caustic Finale. Lots of farm there for Sand King as well, up to a Hood of Defiance and a Blink Dagger. Lots of mobility for him. Only one remaining outer tower for Scarsdale to take down, and they've got two heroes up there already clearing that creep wave. Can very easily get the Alchemist there as well. So top lane's going to be the next one up for Scarsdale to take. Morphing trying to put some push on the mid lane, but Alchemist goes right over there. He's very happy to get some easy farm. Nyx Assassin can get an easy Spike Carapace here. Also has an Aghanim Scepter already. And Mar, okay, as soon as that ultimate's over, oh, they're going to get burned down as well. Oh, is there enough damage? Looks like there could be. The rock doesn't come fast enough. Now they need to do some damage onto the Morphling. Storm Spirit into the fight. Huge amount of damage from East Chapel, and they might have just gotten out. Here comes the Chronosphere on the backside. They need to take down these heroes. Can they do enough damage with the Warlock Golem? The Omni Knight is down. Storm Spirit doing some damage here, and Epicenter coming in from the backside. Can the Sand King actually find the Burrow Strike in? Does some damage with the Epicenter. Storm Spirit getting caught out. Nice impale from the Nyx Assassin, who is still burrowed, and they go right for the Storm Spirit, but away from to the high ground. Cleans up the void, only the Sand King remaining alive, and he'll just Burrow Strike to the low ground and blink away. And that's the first set of Bloodstone charges down on the Storm Spirit, which is an important kill for Scarsdale to get. But still, 3,800 gold. The way of East Chapel High School after that fight. Morphling working towards his next item. Already sending the courier to the secret shop for his Eagle Song. So he'll be picking up the E-Blade very soon. And the damage potential for Scarsdale is extremely high at that point. But Alchemist continues to farm. 1,000 gold on him. Going for the Octarine. Gets so much gold from all these creeps. But Morphling is getting back up there in farm as well. I mean, he's definitely shown that he can farm other heroes. Three body with a massive Juggernaut in game number one. Warlock in a lot of trouble by the Storm Spirit. I don't think he can get away from this. Can he, though? The heal is pretty massive. And now the Storm Spirit out of mana. He's gone too hard. That Radiant's taking him right down. He uses the first suicide of the game. So now the push goes in on the tier 2 tower. Again, no Alchemist for this one. He's gone back over towards bottom. Says, there's farm here. I want it.
Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
We'll take that.
So tower taken down to about half health. Chronosphere is still available for the void. Maybe Falcon Mist were going to commit a little bit more to these, but he's still wanting to build up the Octarine core. He's not 7 slotted yet. He's not 8 slotted, and he hasn't given Aghanim Scepters to his entire team. So Alchemist, he's definitely got a long ways to go here. 3 body trying to get away from here. Morphing up the strength, getting chased down by the Alchemist. He's just chasing him right now. We'll be able to try to TP out. Can he cut your... Oh my gosh. He tried to cut the trees down. Couldn't find the Morphling though. That was also English that I was speaking there. Nyx Assassin just wishing his Storm Spirit Godspeed in the mid lane. Oh, and as soon as SHS go into the Roche Pit, they're going to get scanned. But exactly what can East Chapel do here? If they have the control for Alchemist, they can definitely find the kill. But we'll have to see, because this Roshan's dropping very quickly. Void going with the old Lincoln's build. Here comes the Storm Spirit. No suicide for him for another 3 minutes. Oh, Roshan's low, and Alchemist is out of the ultimate right now. Freedom Fries, he'll get outside the pit. Roshan's very low. Here comes the rock onto a few. Storm Spirit's kind of stuck on the high ground, and he's very low on mana as well. Alchemist has his ultimate up right now, and these heroes are just evaporating. Wraithcat's still in the middle of that burrow, and eventually gets taken down. The only thing that Storm Spirit can do is just try to hope for some kind of steal. And he does not have vision of the pit. Oh no, and no. He's going to go right in the middle of everything. He's going to TP away. So he's just going to force Alchemist to stun himself. A Manta style available for him to... available for him to dodge that stun. So the push comes in on bottom. I feel like East Chapel. All right, Storm Spirit going for the memes. Not even going for the memes. He goes for them wrong. He just zip-zaps in and doesn't TP out. Pretty sure that TP out is the play there. All right, so Scarsdale ready to go in again. They send in the Alk. He's getting his Octarine Core delivered to him right now. Eats that Illuminate to the face. Sending a couple of illusions, but Morphling will make one of him. Or just wants to burn it down a little bit more. Wraithcat being the defense tower from inside the ground. Burning a little bit inside that acid spray. Mar does have his ultimate up in 15 seconds. Oh, the impale's going to hit. Lincoln's Fear popped on Void. That's the mana burn coming through.
All wands will break.
Alchemist Illusion is going to keep the mid lane pushed in. Burning that down. They want to kill these Illusions. Okay. Shotgun comes through, takes the Sand King down to half health. And all the mana is taken away from him as well. Illuminate is going to be there. Now the Alchemist to the high ground. Can they actually defend this? He's going to want to try to stop those impales from coming through. And oh, nice by Carapace, keeping Faceless Void there while he's looking for the Chrono Spirit. But eventually it is going to happen. But he's still going for the Guardian Angel and Omni Knight. Eventually he does kill off the Coddle. Green Fries has to try to stay alive. Wraithcat's still sitting in that burrow. Ready to take these guys down a little bit more. Fudge in so much trouble. Can he actually get killed off? Nice E-Blade. Keeping Sand King out of there. But that's the first strikes of the game going the way of Scarsdale. Mars just so tanky at this point. Here comes the Storm Spirit. Right for a couple of heroes. But now he's going to get absolutely gangbanged there. Oh no. That is not what you want as a Storm Spirit. He doesn't have buyback either. Down for 35 seconds. 4 charges left on the Bloodstone. Oh, Alchemist nearly dead, but he still has the Aegis, and they can't even kill him just yet. He's going right for the tower. Doesn't care about all this damage that's coming through. Void nearly dead. One hit from the Morphling is going to do it. Mar needs his ultimate up. Does have it, but they're just going to straight back up right now. So right now Mar at 3,300 damage. East Chapel. They're kind of feeling their time dwindling down here, looking for a kill on the mid lane tower. Wow, 20,000 net worth lead for Scarsdale. And about half of that is the Alchemist. Oh, Malone in so much trouble. Nyx Assassin doing some work on the backside. Horses aren't going to be there. Mana Burn still doing some work. Lincoln Sphere gets popped. Oh no, stay away from the Nyx Assassin, Malone. Stay away from there. Nyx Assassin, he's still forcing in. And he'll TP out. Alright. So with all their personnel up and mostly healed up, all ultimates as well. Scarsdale pushing the mid lane. Very low at time that the Alchemist ultimate is not up. So the push continues for Scarsdale, trying to make sure that East Chapel don't have any room. There's no hero like the techies that we had in game number one. No one that can really stop Radiant's East Chapel. Nyx Assassin trying to do as much as he can here. Radiant's top tower, it's only so much. Wraithcat watching his team start to go down the drain. Push comes in on the top lane. Impale hits onto the void. Lincoln's popped. Wraithcat four stabs away. And here comes the Alchemist Illusions doing some very little damage to the tier 3 tower. We'll see where Scarsdale decide to go here. Dropping down the Acid Spray, and they want to keep that lane push out as well, so they have the possibility of going for two. Void, there's the Chronosphere available. Just go to the high ground though. Wraithcat, he's burning down the Radiance, but he's healing up as well. Alchemist Illusion going to be made. Alchemist taking a lot of damage. Still doesn't have the Aegis. Here comes the Chronosphere onto two, but the rest of his team isn't really helping. Epicenter coming in. Here comes the Sand King going right for the Morphling. Epicenter, Burrowstrike onto a few. Morphling still trying to regen. Waveform's going to be through, but he's taking way too much damage. Mar finds a kill, and Storm Spirit's back into this one. Freedom Fries takes a lot of damage, but Alchemist only has eyes for the mid tower, and Storm Spirit buys back right into a death. Wraithcat, he's been seen, and he's been killed. East Chapel High School. They did show a great fight in game number one, but they've already lost two sets of racks here in game number two, and they might have just lost the series over to Scarsdale. On the back of an extremely farmed Alchemist, they lose their Warlock, but it looks like that might be about all that East Chapel are able to get. Alchemist going for the Megas. He's been an objective focus this entire game. So they take one, they take another, and definitely keep going here. Can the Storm Spirit and the Morphling stop anything? Oh, E-Blade combo used. Undying is killed. That's a gem on the ground. On Unite, though, he's just completely stuck here. Ugh. I mean, even if... there's a chance that you kill this Alchemist, but even then, you have Mega Creeps going into your base. There's a lot of magic damage. Like, look how much this Alchemist can actually die. Like, he's got killed off there. So it's not like East Chapel Hill are, like, not able to do anything. It's just they did everything a little bit too late. Creeps are inside the base. Creeps creating havoc all over the place. Finding Light in the middle of this. Can they actually... yeah, they found the Faceless Void. Send it back in there. Oh, Burrow doing... oh, nice. Nice stun by Freedom Fries. Lincoln's gets popped. And, oh, can he do enough? There's an E-Blade. Yeah, he definitely wasn't getting out of there. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Tier 4 towers are going to the Mega Creeps. East Chapel are going to find themselves very hard-pressed to defend their base right now. But they're just having fun, I'm sure. Center coming through, and Sand King blinks away. What the? All right. Well, he might have gotten killed off now. Over here now.
Touché.
Dire victory.
Well, the GG was already called by East Chapel, so. With that being said, Scarsdale are going to take the 2-1 victory in the High School Star League quarterfinals in their playoffs, so the winner division. So, congratulations to them. They will be facing PHS in the next round, the semifinal. So, thank you all for watching. It's been a lot of fun covering this series for you guys. And hopefully we have some more action for you guys next week in the High School Star League Dota 2 League. So, thank you all for watching. I'm Pithy Legume. If you want to find out when we're going live with our High School Star League action or with some other things, make sure you follow me on Twitter at Pithy Legume. And for other fun things, twitch.tv/PithyLegume. Thank you all for watching. It's been a pleasure. But for me, the rest of HSL, and our two teams here, I want to thank you for watching and wish you a good night. Stay classy, guys.